Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Sandra Jones. This week, a science investigation is underway that could improve our understanding of hurricane intensification, and the latest space station crew members have been busy adjusting to life back in space. Not all science experiments aboard the International Space Station require heavy crew involvement, thanks to increasing automation and coordination with ground teams. The European Space Agency's Atmosphere Space Interactions Monitor is one such example. This Earth observation facility studies severe thunderstorms and their role in Earth's atmosphere and climate using upper atmospheric lightning. This lightning, also known as transient luminous events or terrestrial gamma ray flashes, occur well above the altitudes of normal lightning in storm clouds and include phenomena with names like red sprites, blue jets, and elves. The space station's low Earth orbit provides an ideal platform for measuring upper atmospheric lightning. By studying upper atmospheric lightning, we can improve our knowledge of the effects of dust storms, pollutants from cities, forest fires, volcano on cloud formation, and electrification, as well as our understanding of hurricane intensification and the relation to eyewall lightning activity. This insight could be especially beneficial back on Earth, as June 1st marked the official beginning of Atlantic hurricane season, and tropical activity is already underway. NASA astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley, the latest space station inhabitants, have been busy adjusting back to life in space following their historic launch on May 30th aboard the SpaceX Crew Dragon vehicle. They took a few moments to reflect on their new normal aboard the orbiting outpost.
It's going pretty well. We've just gone over our first week in space this trip and been very busy. We even got to work a little bit on Saturday fixing our treadmill. So all in all, it's been great. It's great to spend time with Chris. He's a great crewmate. And of course, Bob and I are just trying to get our space legs, and hopefully we can contribute to the science. And we're doing a lot of transfer with the HTV vehicle up here, and then we're getting ready for some EVAs at the end of the month. So a lot going on right now.
This week's question comes from Michael, who wants to know if you can see the International Space Station without the use of a telescope. Well, Michael, the space station is the third brightest object in the sky and is easy to spot if you know when to look up. Visible to the naked eye, it looks like a fast-moving plane. You can check to see when the space station is flying over you next by heading to the Spot the Station website. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag AskNASA. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.